At Eureka Creek, Tony's dredge is out of action. He's still 223 ounces short of his 2,000-ounce, $2.4 million goal. He's come up with a radical solution.
Monica, I would like you to get your own wasp plant set up right beside the dredge.
Kevin!
A bolt has failed on the clamp, holding together two sections of the cast iron pipe. It's a simple fix. Replace the stripped bolt and refit the gasket and clamp.
It's as good as it's gonna get.
Well, any particular reason why we're not going then? Monica? It's your party, so figure that out.
Kevin!
Finally, it is the moment of truth.
Woo! 22-year-old Monica is finally up and running with her own operation.
Thanks, guys.
Any.
It's your baby now. Put it together, you're gonna make it run.
No, no, see, you made it run, but I'll make it produce.
Well, I got one too. Oh, Jesus Christ, I was working out
like a freight train.
This season, Parker has set himself a target of 4,000 ounces of gold, worth $4.8 million. He's running two claims. Rick must sluice 1,000 ounces from Indian River, while Parker's aiming for 3,000 ounces from his boundary cut extension at Scribner Creek. But the cut is currently delivering only half the gold he needs.
We just keep putting more money in. It's been, a really tough run. Yeah, go ahead.
You better get the down here. Drill just sunk the hole and it's not looking good. Engine's smoking. I need you down here as fast as you can.
That is monumental.
What'd you do?
Backed in a little and then it was just a little too far. Next thing you know, it sunk.
You couldn't walk across that, like, with your legs, let alone an excavator.
100% my fault.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that.
So are you gonna fire me over this?
I haven't decided yet.
It really wasn't that bad when I got in there.
There's nothing to even say about this because of how big of a it is.
I agree.
Yeah, so just, let's just keep mouth shut.
The swamp part is the no-go zone. I didn't really tell them that before they set out here. I thought it was pretty self-explanatory.
Slick, Rick.
Give it.
I'm glad that worked.
Ooh. Yeah.
No damage other than a door, it looks like. So we got really lucky. We could have lost that whole machine. It could be scrap metal. So glad it came out as good as it did.
With just a third of the season left, Parker's less than halfway to his 4,000-ounce, $4.8 million goal. To stay on track for Indian River's 1,000-ounce target, Rick needs just over 100 ounces.
106?
There you
six
go.
On the button.
Holy crap.
Nice.
Let's see what old Lucifer done.
Last week, Parker made less gold than Rick.
Oh, yeah, you're over.
Oh, yeah.
What is it?
116.8.
Oh. Shooter!
10 ounce difference, huh?
Yes! It's from Sluicefair.
Yeah, I mean, this is our best cleanup yet from that boundary cut extension, and it's still half of what we need.
Yeah.
We've been cursed this week. Pumps failing and excavators in the swamp. Still got a lot of gold to find. It's a long ways to 4,000 ounces.
The five remaining members of the Hoffman crew are at the Fairplay mine in Colorado.
Freddie threw us a lifeline, went out on a limb.
It's Todd's last chance to dig himself out of debt.
But we ain't out of the woods yet. Let's just hope that there's some damn gold in this dirt. Today will be the moment of truth when we look in that box.
Woo!
Look at that crap, buddy.
Wow.
It's weird seeing all this gold and not having the guys with us. It breaks my heart. You know why I'm calling, Dave, is I need you back. Well, I tried. 45. 40. 49.9.
Might as well call it 50.
If you add my 19 to that, Todd, we've got almost 69 ounces of gold from Fairplay already.
69 ounces is worth $80,000. But after running costs, it will leave Todd only $20,000 profit. A long way to go towards the $150,000 he owes his crew.
What the heck's going on?
What are you guys doing here?